Good morning, everyone. Anthwolf here, streaming live on Twitch. And once again, our game of choice is even more Final Fantasy XIV. At the end of the last stream, we look a bit different now. We managed to get level 60 and play with our glamour. So let's log in with our new level 60 warrior. And for most of today, we're probably going to end up just looking at the various optional missions we have now, optional quests available at the end of the main Heavensward storyline. Between the last stream and this stream, I was playing around with my house here in the Lavender Beds. I kind of just threw everything together. It doesn't really look particularly well at the moment. It's still a work in progress. I have been spending a bit of gil on it though. Oh, also, I've stabled my company Chocobo. That is also a work in progress. I need to wait another 6 hours for the new plumage to come in. And then I've got to be feeding my Chocobo again. So in the meanwhile, we need something else to carry us into battle. So, what? Midgard Soma, maybe? Yeah, we'll use Midgard Soma, why not? Good morning! So, where should we go? What should we do? Let's go over to Ishgard. How are you doing this early morning? I imagine you have work before long, unfortunately. So fun. 10 minutes. Right. Let's go do this one. There's a few optional missions here, but we'll do them one at a time. We won't grab them all. So we're gonna grab... Hello. You. Sky Pirates. The unquiet trader seems to be scanning the skies in silent desperation. Okay, this trader spent a pretty penny on getting an airship built to transport his goods, and he's afraid of sky pirates. Apparently with Cid assisting Ishgard, airship travel has become more and more popular. Go see if we can find out what happened. Don't think we've seen the Protector take to the skies yet. I wonder if it's got repaired. Either way, here in the Sea of Clouds, there's still a dungeon we haven't done yet, and the Chieftain of Okzundu might have a quest that allows us to go to that dungeon. We'll have a look at that later. You don't want to go. I'm like that most mornings. And ended up having a lie-in this morning. I thought I'd kept my alarm for 7 a.m. and I woke up at 10. Well, I woke up a bit earlier, but then I woke up again. I said, oh well, I'll lay in bed until my alarm goes off and I must have fallen asleep again. Rather colourful individuals. So it seems the Sky Pirates have got a hold of a few mana cutters that Sid had developed. Okay, we're heading all the way up here. Okay, I hope it goes quickly for you, and I hope it goes well. 7 hours is a long time, I know, but it can't be helped. The Sea of Cloud's very own ghost ship. Sounds intriguing. We can look into it for him, and for us, of course. Skies. Yutata seems eager to share her findings on the ghost ship. The Void Arc is now accessible. This duty is designed to be undertaken by an alliance of 24 adventurers formed of 3 full parties. When you're in an alliance, the class job icons and HP pause of alliance members will appear for us it appears above our party list. So yes, it's a large scale undertaking. The Void Arc. We'll look to do that probably later on today. Hopefully we can find the 24 members to do it. In the meanwhile, I actually totally forgot we should probably do something. We should probably go back to Curious Gorge. And now that we're level 60, we should endeavor to learn some more skills as a warrior. So, that's exactly what we're going to do. And then we'll head back over to Ishgard and learn more about what it takes to be... Well, learn more about what side missions are available. The Void Arc is rather fun now. I've only ever really done it as a DPS or a healer though, so I may have to quickly read up on how to play it as a tank, in case there's any tanking mechanics I should be made aware of. We also need to speak to Ellie and continue the Hildegard investigations. Benna acts around. Curious Gorge looks eager to expand his combat repertoire. Curious Gorge's brother, Broken Mountain, has maybe discovered more of the warrior's teachings. Curious Gorge had mentioned that his brother could understand his village's ancient texts, whereas he himself struggled. Oh, the Company of Heroes, Captain. So Broken Mountain believes the ancient texts may just be stories. Okay. Heading over to the small settlement east of Revenant's Toll. Speak to the scholars there to see if they know anything of the legend of Mithril Heart. seems like a possible lead. Thought as much. The last scholar we need to speak to is over here. Okay. So while the scholars are looking at Allegan relics, they may have overlooked a more recent relic from a legendary warrior, not realizing someone else may be interested. Ooh. We found an axe. An aged battle axe, featureless but for the initials MH. Crudely engraved into the haft. Certainly possible. I'm sure a lot of people's names begin with MH. Next warrior quest will be available at level 52. It seems we're going to be learning techniques on Broken Mountain now, which I'm fine for. Duty and the Beast. Broken Mountain seems to have reservations about digging deeper into this newfound knowledge. Oh. Well, it did seem he was going to tell us something important, but... seems he's roping us into a situation before he'll tell us more. duty calls, commence battle for duty and the beast. Oh, great. Seems his brother, Broken Mountain, is cutting Curious Gorge off from any further training in the ancient techniques of their village. Because, well, unfortunately, he can't be trusted with them. He loses control. The only way to improve is to test our mettle against the fiercest of foes. Lovely. It's our level 52 warrior quest complete. And we've learned a new action, a new ability called Deliverance. Increases damage dealt by 5%. It shares its recast ability with Defiance. You can have one or the other. Using certain actions under the effect of Deliverance will add to your beast gauge, increasing critical hit rate by a maximum of 10%. Oh, whereas Defiance increases our parry rate. You know, I totally forgot about that again. Do we have any skills that can use... Okay, Inner Beast can be used with their... No, that's only under Defiance. That is also only under Defiance. But I think Deliverance has its own... unique skills. Which we'll proceed to learn a few of now. The Bear Necessity. Broken Mountain has some concerns about his brother. Again. Oh, delightful. So we're heading over to Tail Feather. We need to ask the hunters there if they've seen grizzly bears the size of behemoths. Okay, apparently they have seen one around the 100 throws. Okay, there's a promising lead already. We need to test ourselves, test our inner beast against them. Okay, hunting parties used Willowm Salmon to draw them out. So there's no bonus quests here. We have our beast tribe, of course. There's no blue quests here that unlock new dungeons or raids. Aha. Somewhere. Oh. plenty of bears. Lifeless salmon, the last of its energy spent spawning in the upper Willum River. Despite its size, it was seemingly weaker than a normal brown bear. Maybe because we got guaranteed critical hits with Berserk. Maybe. Back again. Okay. Why do we remain in control, whereas Broken Mountain's brother does not? And now we have learned Fell Cleave. Switches with Inner Beast. I see. Now this is an amazing skill. A potency attack of 520. You don't get, of course, the additional health regeneration or the damage reduction, but Deliverance is used as the DPS side of a warrior. When you don't care about taking the aggro or the threat isn't going to be there anymore, you can switch over. So maybe like Even if you're the only tank, once you've generated enough threat and you're quite far ahead, you could switch over to Deliverance and start just like throwing out the damage. You still, of course, have the aggro or threat generating skill chain. So there's that, of course, as well. Okay. Pirates of Shallow Water. Broken Mountain knows someone in need of a legendary adventurer. So I wonder if all the skills are like that. They switch over depending on what stance you're in. Probably have those Serpent Reavers or some such. The pirates in the Shahagan spawning area. Causing trouble. Let's go see what the situation is and how we can resolve it. We need to find the Serpent Reaver captain and slay him. We'll keep defiance on. I like the boost to our health. Oh, there we are. Looks like that warrior is also on the same quest, so we'll let her have a bit of fun. We'll deal with them afterwards. Sorry, while we wait. Let's get our air. Let's get our beast gauge increased. Sounds clear. Oh. She's dead. Well, that's not a good sign at all, is it? She... Well, never mind. Maybe that's the secret then. We're fighting so ferociously to protect people. Whereas maybe Curious Gorgeous fighting just to maybe satisfy like the thrill or the bloodlust. Recollections of past battles. Rouse the inner beast once again. Now, if I switch to Deliverance, we do keep our Beast Gorge. Awesome. Okay, I wondered about that. I wondered if we kept how much charge we'd gained. And we've learned a new skill, Raw Intuition. I'm not sure how I should use this. Parries on all physical attack. Oh, sorry, parries all physical attacks taken from the front. But all attacks from the rear and flank result in critical damage to yourself. So if you can position, it's great. If you can't, it's going to go horribly wrong. How to train your warrior. The Storm Captain would hear more of our battle. wonder if I should make my UI just a little bit smaller. How does that look? Does that look a bit... Thing is, then it's if you've got a smaller viewing window, then that's a bit more awkward for you to see. But it gives you more view of like the action. I mean, that's not bad. Let's just stick with 90%. Because then we can play with our HUD a little bit better. List can stay there. The beast gauge, I guess we can move a bit closer now. Let's have a look. What does that look like? Gives us more view of actually what we're doing, and like we can see more action going on. Yeah, I like that. We'll stick with that. We might, if we can, if we don't like it, we can always change it back later. Seems curious Gorge got himself wounded. Hey Gorge, how are you doing? Thank you. Okay, we'll leave him to think for now. We may have a possible solution that he resolved to find out himself. Throwing himself onto the explosives the kobolds had developed. Level 58. Slap and chop. Broken Mountain has something urgent to discuss with you. Seems Gorge has really lost his spirit. Slapped the fear out of you. We can do that. So the kobolds are developing more explosives. We are defending the narrow choke point. Okay, we're defending the east. Curious Gorge is helping defend the west. Let's get this done. Wow, nice job. Thank you. Seems Curious Gorge came through all right. More, we've roused the inner beast and learned a new technique. Equilibrium. It is a self-heal. Restores own HP when used with Defiance. Also restores 200 technique points if you're using Deliverance. Handy. We'll take that. That's a reasonable heal. With a 1 minute cooldown? That's pretty damn good, actually. What level can we use that at? Level 58. Okay. And my axe. Broken Mountain is steeling himself for the decisive battle. Mountain's gonna come out with some healing magic. Okay. God, you have to have more faith in yourself, man. I'm not going to be around to slap you every time you get worried. Can you not change the position of the chat window? Interesting. I was actually going to move it a little bit lower. Okay. Time to defend Camp Skull Valley. I think we have the Southern Gate, whereas the Maelstrom will be defending the northernmost gate. The Storm Marshal's here. Whoops. There you go. I just wanted to get some of my inner beast roused. Prior to the fight itself. Here we go. Would you like to commence the battle for and my axe? Indeed we shall. reasonably well so far. Uh-oh. I think he got a bit too excited. Bloodshed, our inner fury has awoken. Thank you. It seems Curious Gorge has got his inspiration, his will back. And we learn Decimate. This concludes the Warrior quests for the Heavensward expansion. To undertake the next series of class quests, we must have Stormblood. And we must have completed the main scenario quest, The Far Edge of Fate. Once you've done that, you can speak to Curious Gorge once again. I am the Warrior. Happy days! So, let me guess. Yep, Steel Cyclone has now become Decimate. It is more damage, but Steel Cyclone does increase threat, and it does absorb a portion of the damage as health. Okay. We may as well help out here. Welcome, Maelstrom. Oh, we have the Ravager's armor. So, what does the Ravager's armor look like? Very much a barbarian king, really, isn't it? Okay. So we all have a whole new series of skills available to us. Really, what we're interested in is deliverance, equilibrium, and maybe raw intuition. Of course, we do have Fell Cleave and Decimate. It depends on whether or not we actually will have another tank in the party. Otherwise, deliverance may not get much use. Like, if we're doing a four-man dungeon, I'll probably just rely on the DPS to do the damage. So, what else do we have? Of course, we need to do the Void Arc at some point. We'll do that later on. Probably after we do some of the duty roulettes. For now, let's get ourselves back over to Ishgard and pick up another one of those new missions that's available. See what else we can indulge in. Just top up my glass while we do that. Actually, tell you what. We will pick up a new quest, but we'll do so in a little while. I'll take a small break, and we'll leave this stream and in a moment exported video to be dedicated to the level 50 to level 60 class warrior missions. But this has been Anthwolf. As I say, I'll endeavor to get this exported over to YouTube, and I'll be back in a little while. And we'll pick up a few more of the available optional side missions slash dungeons. But, obviously, yeah, I'll see you for even more then.